You remember this stitch? We used to call it Joanne stitch. Then somebody told us that it was called mistake ribbing stitch. So this, we have a multiple of 4 plus 1, and I have 33 stitches here, and we're going to separate it in half. And this is very important that you see that on the mistake ribbing stitch, you do need the multiple of 4 plus 1, because you knit 2 and purl 2, and of course you end with 1, which is something that you're going to do in the middle when you separate them. So let's do that. Knit 2 and purl 2. That means we need 16, 6, 8, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, and since we need to end with a knit 1, we do need to add a stitch here so that when you come back and knit with it, you have the amount necessary to make your stitch. So here we have 4, 6, 4, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 15. This one we're going to knit twice. So we are going to knit it from the back, a purl, and then we're going to switch our yarn and we're making a knit, both on the same stitch. Let's do that again. We are going to purl and knit, because we need a multiple of 4 plus 1. You knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, and end with knit 1. Therefore, we needed to add 1 on this side. Now we're going to separate them. We're going to pick up our new yarn. There we go. And we are going to knit the other side with another yarn, with this new yarn. So knit 2 and purl 2. Knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, and end with knit 1, because that's what you need in order to create your stitch. Now we have separated them. This side has 1 yarn, this side has another yarn, and you do switch yarns when you do your ribbing. Let's do this row. So we are going to knit 2, purl 2, because that's the stitch. You always knit 2, purl 2, and end with knit 1. End with knit 1. That's the tail of where you started. We can weave it in later. It's not necessary to do it now. Now we leave that yarn and we pick up the other one. We pick up the yarn that we started knitting with. So here, with the other yarn, of course, because we want to separate the 2 strands for the hat, knit 2 and purl 2. Knit 2 and purl 2. See, we're already separating. We're knitting them at the same time, but they are separate with 2 different yarns. Once I divided it, normally, in order to go around your head, a normal head, you know, for an adult is 22 inches. Normally, you knit 19. And, of course, this is going to cross, so it really doesn't matter all that much, because this is stretchy. So, that's okay. Now, once it's stretched, it's 20. So what I'm going to do is that I am going to make the buttonholes, and this is the way we're going to do it. So we do need two, because I'm using these buttons. So we're going to knit 2, 4, 6, 7 and bind off 2. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then this is the one that we're going to bind off. We need to purl another one. This one we bind off, and then we bind off the next one, and then we have 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 6, 8. Now I think we're going to take one more from this side, so let's do that. We 2, 4, 6, and that's a purl, and a purl, and that's a knit, and we bind off this one, and we bind off this one, and now we're okay. 2, 4, 6, 7, 2, 4, 6, 7, and 8. So now you have to see, this one should have been knitted. Now we have the 2 purls and 2 knits and 2 purls, and you end with a knit. So we do the same thing on the other side. We leave 7 on the side, so we have 2, 4, 6, 7, 2, 4, 6, 8, and the 8 I'm going to leave in the center. So like that it looks
even.
Yeah. 1, 2, 6, 7, 8. That is the one that we're going to bind off. So that's 1 and 2. So we have 8 in the center, 2, 4, 6, 8. That's right. So now we're going to purl this one. So beware, because you have to follow, you need to keep following your stitch. So that's 2 knits and 2 purls. Yeah, mm-hmm. How to put them back. So knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 1, and now we have to turn it.
Turn your knit.
Yes.
Your whole project.
Yeah. And you're so knit that one and cast it on. That's 1. Knit that one and cast it on. And then you turn it, the whole thing. And the next one that we need to knit is knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, knit 1, knit 2, and purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, and end with knit 1. So we're going to repeat that on the other side. So here it is, knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, and now we knit, we turn our whole thing, we go into that one.
Doesn't matter that the yarn's on the other side.
No, just we're going to knit.
Mm-hmm.
We're knitting.
So
it's regular knit. So knit. And you pull. And cast on. And then you knit. And pull. And cast on. See, knit 2, purl 2, knit 2, purl 2, knit 2.
We turn back to our right side again.
Yeah, where the side that we were knitting.
We're purling 2. I'm knitting two.
Knit two and purl two. And now we knit the last one. And now I will be back once I do about 3 or 4 rows of this same thing, because we already have our buttonholes right there. So I'll see you when I finish the 3 rows that I need to make. The way you bind off with this stitch is that you knit 2 and pass the 1 over, and do it a little tight because the stitch is
stretchy.
Yeah, so you don't want it to be all wobbly. So you purl and purl the next, and that is a knit. So I am going to cut that. Always leave a long tail. Pass that through. That's one side. That's my buttonhole. And I'll do the other side and I'll be right back. So what I plan to do with this is that these, of course, there's a lot of videos there everywhere where you can just cross these and sew the beginning with the end, like there and there. And then, of course, you have this that has been crossed and it will look nice. What I want to do is something that is more versatile, so or different. I want to make a knot, an actual knot there, and then I want to put it together here with buttons. So that's what I want to do, a regular knot that looks wide, and put it together there with buttons. And of course these need to be, you know, you need to put them in.
Weave them in to hide them. But we already.
But we, you know, just to show that. Now what I want to do, of course, you can do several things with this. You can cross it twice like this, and then you can put it with the buttons there. See, you can do that. Or you can make your knot, because these are long enough. I have 15 inches, 14 and a half, 15 inches. Let's see, yeah, 14 and a half. And then from the separation to here, I have 6 inches. So 6 inches is enough. You can even stretch it a little, make your knot, and you have your buttonholes there. And we're going to put the sew the buttons in, and I'll be right back to show you how it looks. It's very important when you have a headband or something that you see on both sides, try to hide your yarn when you pass it through. Try to hide it real well.
Do you need to?
But you know, you don't want it to stick out. Uh-huh. See? You can't see it at all now.
That's true.
So you do that on the other side, and then you do that with that one there. And what you're going to do with this is that you are going to make your knot. And put your headband like so. Pass it through your buttonholes. Look how pretty that looks.
Yeah, you can make it with a knot, or if you get tired of the knot, just use it crossed.
And then
crossed.
Cross it once.
Mm-hmm,
or cross it twice.
Mm-hmm. That looks really cool too.
Yes. Because since the tails are long enough so that you can do whatever you wish. So that looks very cool also. See?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that looks really nice.
So you can do whatever you wish. This is a very versatile headband.